survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Thanks for joining us here at Family Feud, where tonight two Aussie families will be battling it out for some big money, and one of them might even go on to win a car. You just never know. Let's meet them now. First up, for their third night from New South Wales, the Dart family. Great to have you guys back. You've already won some money. Now it's time to win some more with who?
This is my lovely wife, Amanda, my brother, Wes, and my sister, Nat.
Good to see you guys back again. And ready to take them on from Victoria, the Petersen family.
How are you?
Yeah, pretty good. A bit nervous.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Who have you brought with you for comfort and moral support?
This is my fiancé, Ben, my dad, Brian, and my cousin, Mahalia.
Righto! Team captains, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name a job where you have to speak loudly. Lee.
TV presenter.
That's right. Oh! How about you, right then?
Teacher.
Teacher!
Well done. Nice. Can't
stop that. You're fine, you're fine. You're fine? Okay, let's go. Ben, good to see you.
I see you too.
Are you related to the Darryl Lee family, as in like the chocolate Darryl Lee family?
Yeah, yeah, my auntie and uncle, they're the heirs of the Darryl Lee fortune, I guess.
What?
What? Heirs of the fortune?
Not me. Not me, but...
Have you ever been to the factory?
I've been twice.
Get out.
Yeah, left with a couple of sacks full of chocolate.
Is it as, like, amazing as you would imagine it to be?
No, not like Willy Wonka, but it's...
Was there a chocolate river?
No, there was no chocolate river. Disappointing. I'm disappointed.
Damn it. Name a job where you have to speak loudly, Ben.
Possibly a foreman?
Let's see. Hey, Brian. Great
hey, Grant.
To have you here.
Thank you.
Name a job where you have to speak loudly.
An auctioneer.
Aha, uh-huh, not bad. I like it when they talk fast. give me out of my prize hands, auctioneer! Yeah. That's pretty good.
Hi.
Lovely to see you.
Nice to see you.
A job where you have to speak loudly.
An actor?
Let's try that. No, that's two strikes now, so the Dart family are going to have to think of an option, Roxanne.
Police officer?
Police officer might
Perhaps.
Have to speak loudly to
Maybe.
Give firm instructions. Let's
yeah,
see.
Yeah, hopefully.
There it is. Ben.
A celebrant? For like a wedding?
Dearly beloved! Maybe.
Maybe.
That's right. Good try, though, Ben. Dart family. Nat, what do you reckon?
I'm thinking coach.
Good. Wes?
I quite like politician. I think they have to speak very loudly.
They get a bit...
In Parliament.
Yeah. Amanda?
I was thinking coach as well, I think.
OK.
I'll go
well,
with
that,
coach.
Technically, you it's weren't
Nat's.
Thinking that.
Yes.
She was.
Sorry. Sorry.
That's called stealing someone else's idea.
That's what I do.
Not I was thinking.
Clever ideas, though, aren't they?
Yeah, as wonderful of that, as that idea was. Lee, yours to choose, actually. Wonderful options for you to go with.
Yeah. I'm going to choose coach.
We're going with coach. Let's give it a shot. Right between the goal posts. Politician. Also there.
And announcer.
So it's a 51-point lead right now to the Dart family. If one of these families goes on to win for 5 nights in a row, they'll be driving home the amazing Mitsubishi Outlander. That was loud. You think I'm a TV host, that's what you do. This family SUV seats 5 comfortably and it's packed with features including touchscreen audio, CVT auto with paddle shift and eco-drive support. For everybody playing along at home, I want the top answer to this one. Name a famous beach in Australia. We'll be back on the feud in just a moment. Welcome back to Family Feud. It's a fun one tonight. I hope you're enjoying it. Now, before the break, I asked, name a famous beach in Australia. The top answer was...
Bondi!
Well played. Give me Amanda, give me Ben, let's do it.
Swap hands. Oh, okay. No, let's do this one. Sorry. Sorry.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name a type of hat. So you should have gone with your left. Because you missed it by about half a second.
Yeah, too slow. Damn.
Ben, a top hat? Top hat's not bad. Yes. Righto. Why are you annoyed by people who beep goodbye, Brian?
I just think it's entirely superfluous. You know, you've said goodbye, they've said goodbye.
They're now in their car leaving the Vic and they're leaving the premises and they go for the bit of a beep beep goodbye.
So is the car saying goodbye? Is the person saying goodbye? Because they've already said goodbye. So
you're doubling up. It's, yeah. You're right, it's excessive goodbying.
Yeah.
Why are people so goddamn nice, Brian?
There's something wrong with them. Should be stopped.
You've thought about this a lot.
Not really.
Yeah. I'm glad that we've worked it out, though. This is kind of a bit like therapy for you, Brian.
Yeah, I can sleep tonight.
Yeah. Type of hat, Brian?
The one I see all the time is the old baseball cap.
So we're going with baseball cap?
Yes.
Hat, Malia?
I'm a beach person, so I'm going to go with sun hat.
Let's try that. Sam, this is fun so far for you guys. You enjoying yourself?
Yeah, definitely.
Cool. Type of hat?
Fedora.
A fedora. Oh. You got 3 left on the board there, Ben.
A bowler hat.
A bowler hat, yeah. If you're going old school. 2 left on the board. You got some great points here, Petersen family. Brian, what you got?
Cowboy hat.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what, Marley? You know what a great way to respond to them taking the first game tonight is to smack them out of the park by taking a clean sweep. What's number 5? One to go.
Oh, visor? A visor.
That's just like the peak thing, yeah.
Yeah.
What about visor? Is that number 5?
Oh.
It's only the first strike. It's cool. One to go.
I'm not actually sure if it's a hat.
Right.
But what about the things that the Jewish people wear?
The religious hat thing.
Yeah, I'm not actually sure what it's called.
Okay, well, this might make it a little bit difficult then. Is number 5 what she said? No. 2 strikes down. Darts gets it for the steal. Ben, you got to save the family. There's only 1 left on the board, man, and you got all the points.
I've
what
got
is
a couple,
it?
But maybe more of an Australian, a baggy green.
Ooh, that's a cool hat. What about baggy green? 3 strikes. Darts get a shot now. Nat.
I'm thinking a cobra.
Ooh, nice. Where's?
Yeah, being in Melbourne, I thought of the fascinators the ladies wear to the Melbourne Cup.
Delicious, Wes. Lovely suggestion. Is that your choice of clothing every spring carnival?
I've never tried one, Grant, but I'm open to it.
You've observed one or two. Amanda.
I was thinking beanie.
Yep, nice. Lee, wonderful options. All very different. All
they
hats,
are.
Though.
A cobra.
We're going a cobra. We're going domestic. We're going Aussie. We're going a cobra. Oh, was that the captain's own choice of which he neglected?
I neglected.
And look what happened.
I've got to be captain, haven't I?
Wow, it's handed control of the competition over to the Petersen family right now. 86 to 51, double points time now. Give me Wes, give me Brian, let's go.
Thank you.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 6 answers are on the board. Apart from ski, name something you can do in the snow. Brian?
Snowboard.
You snowboard? Not the top answer.
Toboggan. Tobogganing.
Is toboggan there? Pass or play, Brian?
We'll play.
Okay, let's go. apart from ski, name something you can do in the snow.
Drink.
She was at the bar.
First strike. I thought it was a good answer. Roxanne.
Build snowman.
Let's try it. Yeah. Ben.
Can I say a snowball fight?
Yes, you can say it, and I like it, but is it there? Yeah, it is. You guys are red hot tonight. Brian.
I don't know how to put it, but make a snow angel where you lie in the snow and do the whole wing imprint thing.
Yeah. Snow angel.
Yeah, snow angel.
I'm going to say go on the chairlift.
You're going to go on the chairlift. How else are you going to get to the top? You're not going to carry all your gear up by foot, are you? That'd be ridiculous. Is that number six? Oh. Two strikes down. Darts, get set for a think. Roxanne.
A bit general, but play in the snow?
You play in the snow as a kid. I like the general thinking. Does it work this time? Three strikes. Nah.
Bobsledder, it might be the same as toboggan, but
no, it's different.
I'm going with bobsled.
Wes?
I'm I've got nothing.
just say fascinator.
Fascinator.
Amanda.
When we went to the snow, they had those great big inflatable tyres that you go on. What are they called? snow tube?
All good options, Lee. What you got?
I'm probably going to regret this, but I'm going to say wee. Wee in the snow. Some people, no, I wouldn't do it. I'm sure there are people that do it.
The whole country right now is collectively going, yeah, right, Lee. Don't eat the yellow snow, says Lee! Well done, congratulations. We hope you're enjoying the show right now. 251, the darts jump to. They have it now. That's their advantage over the Petersen family, who are on 86. Look, you know, there's more Family Feud to be found on 10play. Just click on it to see highlights of the show and things that people do in the snow, for instance, plus our official Family Feud game. Head to 10play, all the details are there. Triple points when we come back. Stick around on the Feud. Again, the Petersen family, you know what, they've been playing awesome tonight. And however, I don't think that score truly reflects how awesome they have been playing. These guys, though, the Dart family, are the master tacticians in stealing all the points. 251 is their score. It's the family who gets to 300 in this round. We'll get a chance at $10,000 and we're playing for triple points now. So give me Nat, give me Malia, let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you would find on a pirate ship. Nat.
A flag? That you know, the pirate flag? Yes.
The pirate flag. There it is.
A pirate?
You'd find a pirate. Well,
Okay.
Off we go. They're learning, Lee. So they're starting to learn a bit of strategy over there.
I think so.
Gives you guys control right now. So name something you would find on a pirate ship.
I'm thinking there has to be a plank.
Yeah.
Otherwise, how do you walk the plank?
How? How do you walk a plank without a plank?
Plank.
Really?
First strike, Amanda.
I'm thinking a captain.
Yeah, to steer the ship. Nice work.
Every ship, even a pirate ship, has to have a cat. So I'm going with a cat. And I do like cats, Graham, so...
Everyone? Every pirate ship wears has a cat.
They do. They've got to catch mice. Yeah.
Is that written like in the
catch rats. Mice?
Okay, cool. Yeah. To get the, to get the ship clean of mice, says Wes. Good answer, just not in our top 8, Wes.
Okay, so I'm thinking that if you're on a pirate ship, you need to be able to fight So I'm going to go with a cutlass or sword.
Not a bad answer.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going very high up on the sheep and I'm thinking of the... I think it's called the eagle's nest, the part where they look out from.
Yeah. Yep. The eagle's nest. Oh. Third strike. Petersen family. This could prove to be a really good decision by making them play first, guys, if you can get this. Malia?
Treasure maps.
Brian?
Scurvy crew.
Ben?
Yeah, I was going to go with crew as well.
Roxanne, you're the captain. One of those options
for
yours.
On.
We need this. It's the triple point round. You currently trail. Hit me with something good.
Well, I don't want to regret going on my own.
Why not? You're the captain.
So I'm going to go with crew.
Crew! No! Dance grab it and become champs yet again. They continue their winning ways. A family feud. Number eight. Roxanne, shake my hand. Well played, Ben. Brian,
thank you.
Good job, guys. Gee, you played well tonight. It was so close. You won't be going home empty-handed. We're going to give you guys the joys of live entertainment with a $1,000 Ticketmaster gift card to be shared between you from the world's leading ticketing agency. And also, you'll be taking home the Family Feud board game. They are the Petersons, everyone. Good try, guys. That's fast money time. Who's in? You liked it so much last time, you've
We're
come back
try
for more.
Again.
You beauty. Do you want to head back to our soundproof booth? Off you go. We play for $10,000 next in Fast Money on The Feud.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Now, welcome back. Fast money time here in the Feud. So let's see if the Dart family can win some more cash.
Thank you.
If you and Amanda can turn a point or more between you, you'll win $10,000. Amanda is now in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers. Is she always
she
smiling?
She is. She is a very happy person.
She is.
I think everybody who meets Amanda loves Amanda, really.
What a wonderful thing. She is a gorgeous human being and successful as well last time. Let's hope you can do it again. I'm going to ask you five questions. Going to give you 20 seconds to answer. If you pass, we'll come back if there's time. And the clock starts at the end of the first question. So are you ready?
Okay. Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Wes.
Thank you.
Just turn around this way. Name the first thing you put on when you get up in the morning.
Shirt.
Name something that scares you.
Falling.
Name a type of pin.
Safety pin.
Name something you do to attract someone's attention.
Shout.
Name a big tourist attraction in Australia.
The Big Banana.
Beautiful. Let's go. Name the first thing you put on when you get up in the morning, and I thought you were going to really jam up on that question there for a bit.
I felt, everything was empty.
You said? Shirt, survey says...
Oh, no!
Maybe not the first thing that most Australians think. Name something that scares you, you said... Falling. Survey says... Four. Name a type of pin, you said. Safety pin, survey says.
I think that's a good answer.
That's good. That's good. Name something you do to attract someone's attention. You said. Shout, like a TV host. That we now know is their number one role. Survey says. 27. Big tourist attraction in Australia, you said the Big Banana. Survey says. Yeah! That came from nowhere. Well done, Wes. Send back the family to the board. Welcome back, Amanda.
Thank you.
So he's done well. Wes really recovered to finish strong, so you needed a total of 94 points to get $10,000. So, yay, that's good news. I'm going to ask you the same five questions, but as you're the second player, as you know, it's a little trickier, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds. Now, if you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time. And if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound, and I'll ask you to try again. So can we remind everybody of Wes's answers and 25 seconds on the clock too, please? The time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck, Amanda. Give me the first thing you put on when you get up in the morning.
Clothes.
Name something that scares you.
Horror movie.
Name a type of pin.
Like your key pin.
Name something you do to attract someone's attention.
Smile.
Name a big tourist attraction in Australia.
Opera House.
Pretty cool. You really are smiling all the time, and I love it. Name the first thing you put on when you get up in the morning. You said...
Clothes.
Clothes. Keep smiling because...
Maybe I should have said slippers.
Well, maybe that would have been a dumb idea because you had the top answer. Yeah! So we now need 61 points to get you guys $10,000. Name something that scares you. You said... Horror movie does.
Yeah, I don't even watch it.
No, you're just...
I have to leave the room.
Yeah. That's not, which is not very social, is it, for everybody else who's come to watch the movie?
No, that's right.
Or it's quite an expensive way to go to the movies.
Yes.
Because you don't
it's
get
not
to
a
see
good
it.
Idea. Yes.
Survey says... Now, spiders was the top answer. Or the dark. You could have had that. That's the second highest. Name a type of pin, you said. A key pin.
I don't know if that's the right word for it.
Let's find out. Survey says... 9.
Uh-oh.
Bobby pin was the top answer. 52 needed now. Name something you do to attract someone's attention. This is so you, this. Because you said... I just smile at them. Like this.
Oh, I know.
Is that really how you get someone's attention?
Well, no, you probably shout at them.
Smile is a wonderful and lovely way to do it, but it's quite a passive way to get someone's attention. But it is gorgeous and it is so you. Survey says...
6.
Wave was the top answer. 46 points needed from this last one now and you can get $10,000. And as you see on the left, well, Wes got 52 points for his answer. Let's see how we go. Name a big tourist attraction in Australia. You said...
Opera House.
Opera House. Wouldn't that be funny if the Big Banana outrates the Opera House as Australia's big attraction?
I think it has.
Is there 46 or more points for $10,000? Let's find out. Survey says... Oh, no! Just, hey, the Big Banana was the top answer! So not $10,000, but $10 for the fast money point. They'll be back again for another shot of the 10. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. I'm Grant Denyer. Good night, Australia.